the glories of Hanumanji. And certainly it's a great initiative, ISKCON Bhagavad Mahavidyalay and Veda Varsity. We have heard about university. This is the first time we are hearing this beautiful term, Veda Varsity. So initiative has been taken by actually the devotees like you, bringing this interface, bringing this wonderful platform so that there can be exchange of knowledge, divine knowledge, spiritual wisdom. So that is, I'm very grateful to you. And there are so many great courses being run by ISKCON Bhagavad Mahavidyalay. So many devotees, they have received the Bhakti Shastri degrees and other advanced courses on the path of Bhakti. So that is, I congratulate all of you for the great work which you are doing. And I request more and more devotees to come and come under the divine umbrella of Veda Varsity and ISKCON Bhagavad Mahavidyalay. So I pray that more and more devotees come and stay blessed under this divine umbrella. And thank you very much once again for inviting me to glorify Hanumanji. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. I'll just offer some prayers and then we will begin. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnana Anjana Shalakaya Chakshuram Ritam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupah Gadamahyam Dadati Subhadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Uttapada Kamalam Shri Guru Nashvashya Shri Rupam Sagrichatam Sagadarap Natanitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagalalita Shri Vishnakantanshya Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesh Gopika Kante Radha Kante Namosute Tapta Kanchan Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanusra Devi Paramami Hari Priye Vancha Tadurveshikapasam Dudevacha Patitanam Pavanevyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shrivasati All of the Wind Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Namo Shripadaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimade Bhakti Vedanta Swaminathan Namane Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschavadishtarine Mukam Karoti Vachanam Pangum Nangayate Girim Kripadaham Mande Shri Guru Dinatha Paramananda Madhavam Shri Chaitanya Hare Krishna. So Hanumanji, certainly he is an emblem of pure devotional service to Lord Shri Ram. Actually, the kind of service, the enthusiasm which he exhibits in his nature and in his services, that's really extraordinary. So today we'll try to discuss some of the pastimes of Hanumanji and through these pastimes, what all we can learn. So we will begin right from the very beginning. That is the birth of Hanumanji. So he's also known as that he's an incarnation of Shivji. So Rudra Shakti, he's one of the 11 Rudras. Hanumanji is there. And we also know that he is Anjaneya. That means he is son of Anjana. Or we also know him that he is son of Kesari. So this also we know that he's son of Kesari. So these are various names which we know about him. Also because he's servant of Sri Ram. So how did he appear as a great devotee? As all of us know that there was Putra Kamishti Yagya, which was done by Rishi Sringa, a very special sage who had horns, and he was a great sage, very, very pure. So he was here there to do the Putra Kamishti Yagya, and I will not get into the details of that. So, but yes, he got, and then there was Yagya Purush, and then there was a huge pot of sweet rice, and the sweet rice pot, the dessert was given by Yagya Purush to Dashrath Maharaj, and Dashrath Maharaj gave first half to Kaushalya. And then 1/4 and 1/4 to Sumitra and then Kaikeyi. So certainly Lord Ram is going to appear to Kaushalya because 1/2 was given to Kaushalya. And then 2/2, 1/4 was given to Sumitra. But she waited. And then Kaikeyi, she also took 1/4. And she immediately took 1/4. So Bharat was born to Kaikeyi. And then because Sumitra, she waited. So that way she was blessed with later on as she took. So she had 1/4. And also, there was 1/8 left by Kaikeyi. So she took half. That means after 1/4, she took 1/8. So 1/8 was still there. So now Sumitra had 1/8 given by Kaikeyi. And also she had 1/4. So with 1/4 which she took, she was blessed with Lakshman. And with that 1/8 which was left by Kaikeyi, she was blessed with Shatrughna. So Lord Ram would be served by Lakshman. And Bharat would be served by Shatrughna. Okay, great. But still this pot was there, which had this remnant of the kheer. So there came Garudji. And he picked up this pot, which was having this leftover remnants, and then gave it to Anjana in South India. And as she licked all that, whatever was left in that pot, and she licked that, in this way, she became pregnant, and then she gave birth to Hanumanji. Also, the story which is there, that when Shivji was running after Mohini Murthy, so when his divine semen, when it fell, so Pavandev got that semen, and then he implanted that semen in the womb of Anjana. So in this way, there is going to be Shakti of Shivji, and Anjana Mai, she is going to be the mother of Hanumanji, and also he is having the remnants. That means the service attitude was there right from very beginning, was there in Hanumanji. Reason being, he took birth, he appeared after taking the remnants of the four great divine brothers, Ram, Lakshman, Bharat, and Shatrughna. So that way, this sweet rice was really special. So we see that right from very beginning, he has this attitude to take the remnants of the Lord. Yeah. So first time when he met Hanumanji, so Hanumanji asked him that, okay, who are you, two great people? Because Sugriv sent Hanuman to know about these two sage-looking people, but they are having the bows and arrows and swords. So that is, they appear to be Kshatriyas. In terms of their clothing, they appear to be sages. So who are they actually? So when Ram and Lakshman, when they were there, so Hanuman introduced himself that I am from Sugriva, who is the king of this place. And then Hanumanji told Lakshman, tell him about ourselves and who we are. And then Lakshman was talking to Hanumanji that we are sons of Dashrath Maharaj, and we have been exiled for 14 years in this world. Lord Ram did not talk to Hanuman. And when Lakshman introduced in this way that we belong to Dashrath Maharaj and we are sons of Dashrath, so then he said, okay, you are Sri Ram. And then Hanuman, he was so happy. He was practically in ecstasy. And then he said, oh, Sri Ram, oh, my Lord, oh, the Lord of my heart today is there before me. Wow, that's so wonderful. That's so great. He said, I'm your servant, Hanuman. And when he said this, that I'm your servant, Hanuman, then Sri Ram started talking to Hanuman. But before that, Hanuman was saying, well, I am servant of Sugriv. So till that time, Sri Ram said, Lakshman, you talk to him. I'll not talk to him till the time he reveals his identity that he belongs to me. Mm-hmm. And then Hanumanji, as soon as Hanumanji said, well, oh Sri Ram, I'm your servant, Hanuman. And then Sri Ram was very happy that, yes, now you're talking about your true identity, that you are my devotee. You belong to me. And then Lord Ram started talking to him. So in this way, when we are also lost in this world, having this identity crisis, we identify ourselves with somebody's brother, somebody's mother, somebody's sister, somebody's this, somebody's that. Well, excuse me, that's not the way we connect to God. We connect to God when we know that Jivara Swarupa Hai Krishna Nityadas, that we belong to the Supreme Lord, the Supreme Absolute Truth, Krishna or Sri Ram in this case. Wonderful. So that this is how the first lesson which you learn from Hanumanji, that is that we should always recognize ourselves being servant of the Supreme Lord. Now Hanumanji did so many wonderful services, great services. And there also comes one quality which gets highlighted in his services is the quality of loyalty. The quality of loyalty. In some of the versions of Ramayana, like there are four famous versions of Ramayana. One is Valmiki Ramayana, and there's Ramchaitmanas by Tulsidasji, there's Kamba Ramayana by great sage Kamba, and there's also Adhyatma Ramayana by Ved Vyasji. So in these Ramayanas, in one of the Ramayanas, it is mentioned that how he was, when he was guarding the bridge, as the bridge was being made towards Lanka, so one mermaid was assigned by Ravan, that these monkeys are making bridge towards Lanka, you go underneath and destroy the bridge. She said, okay, your highness, I'll do that. And then this mermaid, so she went underneath this bridge and started destroying the bridge. And Hanumanji, he was guarding the bridge. He said, what's this happening? The monkey army with such hard work, they have made this bridge, but here comes, who is this person who is destroying the bridge? He said, excuse me, who are you? Come and fight with me. And then this mermaid, she came outside. And as she came out to the ocean, and when she saw Hanumanji, wow, what a handsome, hunky guy. Wow, such illustrious person, such an effulgent person. Wow. And Hanumanji said, who are you? How dare you break the bridge, destroy the bridge? Don't you know that we are servants of Sri Ram and we are trying to make this bridge towards Lanka with such hard work? You nonsense! You have to fight with me. And then Manmad said, well, to fight with you. I'll fight with you. And then she started fighting with Hanumanji. But sometimes she would hug Hanumanji from this side, sometimes from this side. And then Hanumanji said, nonsense! Nonsense! Are you fighting or are you flirting? Nonsense! She said, actually, Hanuman, you are so handsome. You are so good looking. Wow. So on the pretext of fighting, I was just touching you. That's it. And then Hanuman said, please, get lost. I was loyal to Sri Ram. I am loyal to Sri Ram. And I will continue to remain loyal to Sri Ram. Please. And then she said, wow, you are handsome. You are hunky. You are pure. And on the top of it, you are loyal to Sri Ram. Great. I thought I have my master Ravana, but today I have got my real master. That's you. That's you. So I resigned from the office of Ravana and I want to join your office. You are servant of Sri Ram and I would serve you as your maid servant. Yes. So I'm no more mermaid. I'm just a maid servant of Sri Hanuman. And I would also contribute in making the bridge towards Lanka. And then she was purchased by the purity, by the devotion, by loyalty of Hanumanji. Wow. That is, he is always very loyal. In fact, when he reached Lanka, and as he reached Lanka, now he did not know where is Mother Sita located. So he went into the palace of Ravana, which was on Trikut Parvat. And on the Trikut Parvat, the central hill, which was tallest, he managed to be there. And then he was searching for Mother Sita. And as he went into the inner quarters of Ravana, there he saw many hundreds and thousands of ladies. Some were covered, some were partially covered, some were clothed, some were not so much clothed. And he's a brahmachari, he's a monk. But since his loyalty, his devotion is so deep, is so unshakable, is so impeccable, that even though when he was in Lanka and he was seeing all of these ladies and he was inspecting, is she Mother Sita? No. Is she Mother Sita? No. Is she Mother Sita? No. But he did this in service to Sri Ram. Finally, he reached Mandodari. Now, Mandodari was exact replica of Mother Parvati. So after seeing Mandodari, he said, yes, I have found Sita. Yes, certainly she must be Sita. But as he observed closely, he could see some of the flaws in Mandodari. He said, no, my Mother Sita, she's flawless. She's flawless. Since I'm seeing some of the faults in this lady, so she may be some great person, but she cannot be Sita. No. And then he moved ahead. And finally, of course, he met Mother Sita. But here we see that a monk should not even talk to the ladies intimately. What to speak of seeing them, and that too when they are not properly clothed. But his devotion to Sri Ram was so thick that there was not even a tinge of contamination in his heart, in his consciousness while doing this seva. So he is so very exalted in his loyalty to Sri Ram. Wow. So that's the quality which we learn from Hanumanji. Also, Hanumanji is very respectful. He's very respectful to the devotees as well. He's respectful to Sri Ram, no doubt. At the same time, he's respectful to the devotees as well. Lakshman was there to assist Sri Ram in this great journey. Of the 14 years of exile. Very adventurous journey. But when Sri Ram and Lakshman, when they met Sugriv. Now Sugriv, being a neophyte, what did he do? As soon as he saw Sri Ram, he gave a seat to Sri Ram, but he did not give seat to Lakshman. So Lakshman was still standing and Ramji was sitting. And then, out of arrogance and out of his neophyte nature, Sugriv sat next to Sri Ram. So, who are you? Where are you coming from? This and that. And Lakshman is standing. He's sitting next to Sri Ram. Now Sri Ram became a little uncomfortable. That my brother Lakshman, he's standing. And this person is talking to me as if he's my childhood friend. And Hanumanji could detect this immediately. Immediately, he got some of the leaves from the branches, and then he created this on the elevated platform. He placed all the leaves and he said, respected Lakshmanji, please kindly be seated. And then he took Lakshman with great respect, made him seated on that exalted seat, and he himself sat at the lotus feet of Lakshmanji. And when he did that, he looked at Sri Ram, and Ram looked at Hanuman. This is what I was expecting from Sugriva, but he's a neophyte devotee. You are an advanced devotee. I like this gesture, that firstly you gave place to Lakshman to sit, and secondly you sat at the lotus feet of Lakshman. Wow, that's what you call the gesture. Once this happened, that Lord Ram, he asked him, Hanuman. He said, Hanuman, you know, I love you more than Lakshman. I love you more than Lakshman. What do you have to say about this? So Hanumanji said, well, yes, that's true. You have said that you love me more than Lakshman. But usually people say, well, I love you more than my heart, more than my life. I love you. So by saying that you love me more than Lakshman, it means Lakshman is your life. Lakshman is your heart. So you are very correct, my dear Lord. He's actually your heart. He's your life. I understand that. Sri Ram said, okay, very good. Lakshman, what do you have to say about this? Lakshman said, well, my Lord, you very rightly said that you are more dear, Hanuman is more dear to you. Because I, as Anantashesh, I carry you. But he, as an Hanuman, he, on his one of his shoulder, he carries you. On another shoulder, he carries me. So the one who is carrying the Lord, as well as Anantashesh, who carries the Lord, is certainly greater a devotee than me. Because I only carry you. But he is carrying me as well as you. So that is, you are absolutely right, Sri Ram. You are absolutely right. So both of them, they were having mutual appreciation for each other's services to our Sri Ram. Bharat was the one who did service in separation, with the feeling of separation. But Lakshman and Hanuman, they got direct service to Sri Ram. But both of them are so much appreciative of each other's services. Wow, that's really great. So he had so much respect for Lakshmanji. That means he had respect for Guru. There are people who respect God, but not Guru. And there are people who respect Guru, but not God. But we have to respect both. And this lesson we can learn from Hanumanji. Hanumanji had respect for Lakshmanji. Also, he respected Sri Ram. He would chant the names of Ram. But he was also at the same time very conscious to serve Lakshman. When Indrajit hit with his very powerful arrow, Lakshman. And Lakshman was unconscious now. So at that time, Hanumanji took this task that within a day, I'll accomplish this task that I'll bring Sanjeevani booty. Very special medicine. Actually, three medicines were required. One was Mrit Sanjeevani, which makes a person come to life. Second was Shailya Karani is which repairs all the wounds, quick healing of the wounds. And there was another one, Sandhani. Sandhani means that which does sandhi of the bones in case there is a fracture. So Sandhani would make that bone join immediately. So Sandhani, Shailya Karani, and Mitra Sanjeevani, all the three of them were required. So Hanumanji went there to find these three medicines, but he did not know. He did not know how do these medicines look like, especially the Mrit Sanjeevani. So he brought entire mountain with him. And then he offered this mountain. And then, of course, Vibhishan was there to offer medical aid to Lakshman. No doubt, Lakshman cannot be made unconscious by any kind of weapon. That was the will of Sri Ram. Because he knew that from past 14 years, my brother has not slept in my service. I want him to take some rest. So by the divine will of Sri Ram, Lakshman became unconscious. In a way, he took some rest. Because from past 14 years, he has not slept in service to Sri Ram. Wow. But here is Hanuman. In single day, he brought the mountain, got everything done, and then took this mountain back to its original place. Great. So he is not just externally respecting Lakshmanji, but also he had service attitude towards Lakshman. Wow. So that's another lesson which we learn from Hanumanji. Another lesson which we learn from Hanuman is that he is having great faith in Harikatha. Yes. When all the monkeys were there with him, Jamvanji and Angad and all the monkey army who they were searching, and the time which was given to them was 1 month's time, that they are to find Mother Sita within 1 month's time. Now this was the last day of that 1 month. And all of them, they became so disappointed because Sugriv told them, in case you come back empty-handed, I'll slash all of you. I'll kill all of you. All those will come with no news for Mother Sita. So they decided that instead of getting killed by Sugriva, let's die here, chanting the names of Ram. At that time, seeing their despondent and disappointed state of condition, so Hanumanji started doing Harikatha. He started glorifying Sri Ram. And as he was glorifying Sri Ram, immediately all of them, they revived. They were again become, they again became their enthusiastic in service to Sri Ram. So they were enthused. And when Hanumanji, crossing over the ocean, he reached Lanka. And finally he reached Mother Sita. Mother Sita, she was in feeling of separation from Lord Sri Ram. And she would often be talking to one green color flower and one white color flower. Green color flower means that Sri Ram. And this white color flower, that means Lakshman. She would be talking. And then sometimes, in one time, she became so much disappointed with herself that she said that maybe Sri Ram may not come. You know, Sri Ram, since he might have decided that he may not come. So what will I do without meeting him? So let me commit suicide. And then with her silky hair, she took off her silky hair and she wanted to just strangle herself and then kill. But since the hair was so silky, so they were all slipping from her hand. But Hanumanji was there in the tree. He was looking at Mother Sita. Oh, that she is looking so disappointed. And then he, from there, he started glorifying Sri Ram. He started singing the glories of Sri Ram. Sri Raghavam Dasharathatmakam Aprameyam Sita Patim Raghukulanvayaratnadeepam Ajanubahum Aravindadalayataksham Ramam Nishachara Nishavinashakaram Namami. And then as he was singing the glories of Sri Ram, and then he started glorifying his pastimes in a very poetic way. And all those wonderful, great moments, he started narrating in a very musical way, in a very nice way. And then Mother Sita, she became lost in that Ram Katha. Yes, that she gave up the idea of committing suicide. She said, no, Sri Ram will come. But who is the one who is doing this Ram Katha? And that with such details. Wow, who is this person? And then Hanumanji, in his small size, he came, oh, Mother Sita, this is servant of Sri Ram. I have come. You, servant of Sri Ram? I know all the servants of Sri Ram. I do not know any servant who is monkey. Who are you? He said, yes, I am. I am servant of Sri Ram, oh, Mother Sita. Yes, I am. He said, you are? Yeah, really? Oh, yes, I have come here to take you. You will take me, just see your size, Mother Sita said. Just see your size. How can you take me across the ocean? He said, yes, Mother Sita, I can do that. And then he started chanting the names of Ram. Ram, 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 Ram. And then he had this huge size. And then Mother Sita, she became really anxious that somebody may not see this huge form. She said, okay, come back to your that size. And then immediately, then Hanumanji again was back in small size. Yes, Mother Sita. Yes, I can take you. I can take you. She said, okay, you must be a devotee of Sri Ram. Because the one who glorifies Sri Ram in such a beautiful way. Secondly, the one who chants the name of Ram with such heart into that name of that in that chanting. You must be a devotee of Sri Ram. Yes. So these two are the qualities. These two are the qualities, a hallmark of a devotee. The one who chants the name from the core of his heart, and the one who has got immense attachment to Hari Katha, Sri Ram Katha, Krishna Katha, Gaur Katha, the one who is having such an attachment, he is the one who is the devotee of the Supreme Lord. Yes, that's the hallmark of a devotee. So immediately she identified there. Yes, you must be a great devotee of Sri Ram. Maybe I do not know, but yes, you are a great devotee. But then she asked one very interesting question. She said, please tell me, what is your actual size? Is this your actual size, the small size? Or is that your actual size? So what is your actual size? And Hanumanji gave a fabulous answer. He said, oh, Mother Sita, my real size is this. That means I'm very small. My real size is that I'm very small. But in service to Sri Ram, I can take any amount of services. Wow. Great answer. My actual size is that I'm very small. But in service to Sri Ram, I can take any size. And that's the consciousness of a devotee. A devotee of the Lord always feels that I'm a small person. I'm an insignificant servant. I'm very small. Yes, I'm very small. But yet at the same time, a devotee never hesitates to take big responsibilities just to please the Lord. Not that I'm so small that I cannot do any service. Well, that's not humility. That's inferiority complex. These are two different things, inferiority complex and humility. But Hanumanji exhibits humility. So he said, actually, I'm very small, but in service to Sri Ram, I can take any size. Yes. So devotee should also be ready to take any amount of services, big or small or whatever services are required. He should be ready to do that. Yet at the same time, he should feel humble. He should feel small. Yes. That's the way we should be. So Mother Sita, she was very much impressed by this answer. Okay. So that way he has great faith in Harinam and he's having great faith in Harikatha. He started his journey with Harikatha. And when he reached Lanka, he did Harikatha. Wow. And when he came back, he did Sita Katha to Sri Ram. Actually, Ramayana can be said in two ways. Ramayana and Ramayana. When Sri Ram hears it, then he hears it as Ramayana. Rama is Sita Devi. So it's a story of Mother Sita, Rama. Well, Rama is one of the name of Mother Sita. So Ramayana. And when Mother Sita heard, she heard Ramayana. That means glories of Sri Ram, Ramayana. So that is Ramayana is a katha of Rama and Ram. So Ramayana and Ramayana. But Hanumanji is so dexterous in Ramayana as well as Ramayana. In fact, in Ramayana, it comes that Lord Ram blessed Hanuman that wherever there is Ram katha happening, wherever there is Ram Katha happening, you may bless the speaker. So that means currently I'm sitting in my room, in my Brahmachari ashram. So in this room, Hanumanji is there to bless me so that I can glorify Sri Ram properly. And he's also invisibly present there in your respective places as well to bless all of you that you may appreciate Sri Ram Katha. Yes. So that means he is the ambassador for Ram Katha, Hari Katha. Yes. And that is Hanumanji. Yeah. So he's having great faith in Harikatha. Along with that, he's having great faith in Sri Ram, in Harinam, in Ram Nam. He's having great faith, actually. Was Narad Muni, he went on this venture to see that who is the one who does the best of bhajan, the best of kirtan. Who is the one? And then he was told that, well, the best of bhajans are from Hanuman. He said, okay, the best of bhajans are done by Hanuman. Great. So finally he met Hanuman. And then at that time he saw Hanuman. Siyaram, Siyaram, Sitaram, 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 Sitaram. He was doing this. And then Narad Muni said, excuse me, Sitaram, Sitaram, Sitaram. And then he started playing his veena also along with the Sitaram. And then Hanumanji could see that who is this playing this wonderful instrument in my bhajan of Sitaram Naam bhajan? Said, this is Narad Muni. Oh, Narad Muni. Wow. Narad Muni. And then he paid his obeisances to Narad Muni. Narad Muni paid obeisances to Hanumanji. And then Narad Muni said, I have heard that when you chant the names of Ram, so that's really wonderful. So I request you, please sing some bhajan of Sri Ram. I want to hear. I heard it and that was really wonderful. I don't want to disturb you, but I thought that I should make you aware that I am there to meet you. He said, oh, Narad Muni, you have come here. Great. All right, for your pleasure, I'll chant the names of Sri Ram once again. And then again, he started singing, Jai Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram. And as he was saying these names of Sita and Ram from the core of his heart, the heart of Narad Muni was melting. He was in ecstasy. He was shedding tears of love. His hairs were standing on end and his veena fell on the ground. And not just that, even the rocks over there, they started melting. Hearing those names of Sita and Ram. And as they got melted, so the veena got inside this molten rocks. And then Hanumanji stopped. He said, Narad Muni, this was my bhajan to Sri Ram for your pleasure. said, wow, Hanuman, that was really, really, really amazing. Transcendental indeed. Thank you so much. So those who have said that you are the best in bhajan, yes, you are best. You are best. Okay, I will take your leave now. I would like to go now. And as Narayan was preparing to go, he saw that his veena is stuck in the rocks, because the rocks, they were molten by the sound vibration of Hanumanji's bhajan. But as he stopped, so again, they solidified. So the veena got stuck in those rocks. He said, Hanuman, actually, no, you have to sing once again so that I can take out my veena, because my veena is stuck there in the stones, in the rocks. Zulal, I'll not do that. I would like to take a leave now. Okay. Okay. Jai Shri Ram. Okay. And as he started flying, so then Hanumanji, or so then Narada Muni was chasing him. Hanuman, you can do this. Please. You know, my veena is very important for you, because I also chant the names of God. Please, try to help me. Please. You can't do this to me. Please, Hanuman. And then Hanumanji was there roaming around, and then behind him, Narada Muni was chasing him. And finally, he came back to that same place. He said, yes, I will sing. He said, why did you do this to me? He said, well, I know that you are a great soul. I just want this place to be sanctified by the dust of your lotus feet. So that's why I did this. Again, I'll sing the names of Sita and Ram. And again, he started chanting the names of Sri Ram, Sita and Ram. And then the rocks melted, and then Narada Muni could take out his veena. Wow. So that's the depth of his bhajan. Great bhajan is done by Hanumanji. In fact, when he was bringing the rock, that means the Sanjeevani booty, the Brit Sanjeevani booty he was carrying, and Bharaji shot an arrow, and at that time Hanumanji was chanting the names Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, and his chanting was so pure that even that rock which he was carrying with all these medicines, even that rock was chanting Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram. So as the arrow of Bharat hit Hanumanji, so Hanumanji fell on the ground, but that rock, that mountain, was there still in the air. It did not fall to the ground, because even that mountain was chanting the names of Sita and Ram, because here is Hanumanji who is chanting the names. Wow. So his chanting was so deep that he could make even mountains chant the names of the Lord. Wow. And then when he fell, he gave the report that actually I'm servant of Sri Ram. I was carrying the Sanjeevani for Lakshman. And then Bharat said, oh, if I ever chanted even one Shuddha Naam of Sri Ram, may you recover and may all the wounds are covered, become all right, absolutely, right now. He said, well, and then immediately Hanumanji, he recovered, and yes, oh yeah, he was back in service. But again he jumped, Jai Sitaram. And as he jumped, he was there with that mountain who was still there in the air. So that's the depth of chanting of Hanumanji, that the mountain was stuck in the air, it did not fall. Wow. In fact, once, there was a discussion in Ayodhya, who is great? Whether Sri Ram is great or whether his name is greater than Sri Ram? Who is greater? Sri Ram's name or Sri Ram himself? So Narada Muni knew that actually the name of the Lord is more merciful than Lord himself. So once this happened, that there was one king of Kashi. This king of Kashi, he invited various sages, and he just whispered something in his ear, that ears. He said that, well, you know, well, you are paying regards to all the sages, but please do not pay your regards to Valmiki Rishi. All right. Yeah. There are some reasons. I'll let you know later on. Huh? Okay. All right. So this king of Kashi was saying, okay, welcome everyone. As there was Valmiki Muni, he skipped him and then welcome everyone. So Valmiki said, maybe, you know, he's a king. He's a busy guy. So he just skipped me. That's okay. And I don't demand respect. That's okay. But later on, Narada Muni came. Well, Valmiki ji, he did not pay respect to you. You know, these kings, sometimes they become too much in rajas, so much in mode of passion. They need to be teach some, we need to teach some lesson to them. So I think you should rebuke him. You should go to Sri Ram so that Sri Ram can teach him a good lesson. You should do that. Otherwise, the respect for the sages would go down. So please do that. So all right. And then Valmiki Rishi, he went to Sri Ram. He said, well, I got one request. There is one king of Kashi, he did not pay me respect. Not that I expect respect, but his attitude towards the sages is not good. So I think you should kill him. You should finish him off. Sri Ram said, okay, since you have said this, and you are our family guru, Valmiki Muni, Vishwamitra Muni, excuse me. It was not Valmiki, Vishwamitra Muni. So Vishwamitra Muni, please. Yes, I'll take the charge. I'll punish him. So Vishwamitra Muni said, yeah, of course, he should be punished. And then, meanwhile, this king of Kashi, he went, he was saying that, oh, Sri Ram is coming to kill me, what should I do? He went to the jungles and there he met Anjana, the mother of Hanumanji. And he said, please, Anjana, my, please, somehow you protect me. That king of Kashi, Vishwamitra Muni has complained against me, so that means I will be killed now. And then Mother Anjana went to Hanuman. Hanuman, please protect this king of Kashi. Said, all right, Mother, as you order, I'll do that. And then Sri Ram came and there is Hanuman. Said, oh, Hanuman, you are there. No, just leave this king of Kashi, I'll punish him. Said, actually, I've given promise to my mother, Sri Ram. Now, what should I do? Said, what? He said, yeah, I'm bound to protect him now. He said, but I'm bound to kill him now. So, what should we do now? So, okay, all right, let's do our duty then. And then Hanumanji, he made his spiral tail all around the king of Kashi. And he sat on that pile of the tail. And then he started chanting the names of Ram. Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram. And as Sri Ram was shooting arrows, all the arrows which were being shot by Sri Ram upon Hanumanji, all those arrows would turn into garlands on Hanumanji. In this way, all the arrows, they were there, and they were turned into flowers and garlands. And in this way, this is what was happening. And then Ravamani came. Okay, I think I'm here to now settle down this. We can clearly see that even though Sri Ram is there having battle with Hanuman, but Hanuman is chanting the names of Sri Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram. And he's not just protected, but all the arrows of Sri Ramji, they're turning into flowers and flower garlands by the influence of the name. So that means name is more powerful than Sri Ram. The name of Sri Ram is more powerful than Sri Ram. The name of Sri Ram is more merciful than Sri Ram by the will of Sri Ram. That's very important, by the will of Sri Ram. But yes, here we see that Hanumanji is a person who is having such immense attachment towards the holy name. He's very courageous. Yes. And he always acts in a way which is pleasing to Sri Ram. He's very humble. He's very humble. But yeah, at the same time, he's very courageous. Like when he was in Lanka, and then when Mother Sita said, well, you know, I had a dream that one monkey has come to Lanka and he's burning entire Lanka to ashes. And then Hanuman said, maybe that's the will of the Lord. And that's why such a thing has come in dream of Mother Sita. So this cannot be by chance. Coincidentally, all these are atheistic words. Everything happens by the will of the Lord. So that means such a dream which has come to Mother Sita yesterday night. And today she is sharing that dream to me. That means it's the will of the Lord that I should do something. All right. Yes, I'll do something, Mother Sita, in the service of Sita and Ram. And also get to know that what all is the military strength of Ravana. And then when his tail was lit to fire, anywhere he would just touch his tail, that place would catch fire. Otherwise, this Lanka was made up of gold. How can gold catch fire? Gold cannot catch fire. But since Agnidev was instructed by Mother Sita that go and assist Hanuman, firstly, when his tail is lit on fire, you do not hurt him at all. And secondly, wherever he touches his tail, let that place catch fire instantly. And then Hanumanji, as he was having his tail, and he was saying, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Jai Sita Ram. Wherever he was just touching the tail, that place would catch fire. That palace would catch fire. Wow. Now, as he was doing this, he saw that Indra started raining. He said, why are you raining? I had a plan to burn Lanka. And you were just, why the hell you started raining? I know you have the department of rain, but why now? Everything will go in vain because of your rain. But then Indra said, Hanuman, but just see by this rain, whether the fire is getting extinguished or whether it is getting more amplified. He said, well, yeah, fire is getting amplified. He said, yes. So it's raining, but fuel is raining, not water. It is fuel. So I'm just adding fire fuel to the fire. All the best. Good job. Yeah. And in this way, he burnt entire Lanka. And various demigods, various planets who were there in the imprisonment of Ravana. One of them was also Shani. Shani was also released. He said, yeah, come on, go on. Go. Yeah, all of you are released. And then Shani said, excuse me. Who are you? He said, I am servant of Sri Ram. My name is Hanuman. Oh, So you are a Hari Bhakta. I'm also Hari Bhakta, Shani said. Going forward, I promise you, Hanuman, anyone who becomes devotee of Lord Sri Hari, anyone who follows a path of righteousness and devotion and wisdom to Sri Ram, Sri Hari, would be free from my influences. Because as soon as Shani looks at somebody, misfortune starts. Yes. But then Shani said, well, going forward, anyone who chants the name of the Supreme Lord Sri Hari, like we chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, would be free from my influences. Oh, that's great. Wow. So that is, he served all these various demigods as well. Yeah. So we see that again, he being such a great devotee, and he could accomplish all that, those impossible tasks. In fact, once there was one more interaction of Hanumanji. This happened quite later. It happened in Dwapara Yuga. That was time in Treta Yuga. In Treta Yuga, Shani said, okay, I'm so grateful to you. But somehow when Shani met him in Dwapara Yuga, and then he met him, you are that Hanuman, okay. Well, everyone has to face me. So that way, since as per astrological time, so it's time that I should come upon you. He said, Shani, oh, you, yeah, of course, that's your time now. He said, I come for 7.5 years, Sale Sati. And these 7.5 years, that's a tough time for the person. He said, all right, okay, all right. You want to do harm to me? He said, well, that's my duty. Okay, all right. And then Hanumanji, he said, I'll meet you, but since I've got one, I do my Gayatri, I just move across the ocean. And then once I'm done with my Gayatri, and then I'll talk to you. And then meanwhile, Hanumanji just wrapped him around in his tail. And then he moved around in the oceans and rocks and this, that. And his head and shoulders, his body parts was rubbing to various rocks and here and there. And finally, after circumambulating entire earth, completing his Gayatri, after crossing all the oceans, finally he reached to his original place. So he said, okay, yeah. So where is Shani? 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 And then he saw Shani was partially wounded and said, So he said, I'm sorry, what's wrong with you? Said, oh, Hanuman, I didn't know that you will wrap me around your tail and then, you were talking about that 7.5 years. I said, yeah. First 2.5 years, I come on the head. And then as I come in head and then I make the person do all those wrong things. So that's first 2.5 years. And then second 2.5 years, I'm in belly, whatever the person would eat would not digest. And then last 2.5 years, I stay in the feet. That where one is not supposed to go, the person would go and suffer. So this is how I give suffering. So he said, so that means you'll come to my head now. Is that so? He said, yeah. He said, yeah, so you can come on my head. Shall I help you? And then Hanumanji placed Shani on his head. Are you comfortable? He said, yeah. I'm comfortable now. Okay. And then Hanumanji also placed some of the rocks on his head. One after another. Wow. And then he was taking the name of Sri Ram. Jai Sri Ram, Jai Sri Ram. And he was dancing as well. And then Shani was getting completely crushed under these rocks. He said, wow, please release me. Hanuman said, well, are you okay? Now you have to come to my belly and then my feet, right? He said, no, I'm done. I can't do Sare Sati with you. I can't have these 7.5 years with you. But then he could see that Hanumanji could see that Shani is really injured. He said, Shani said, well, why did you do this to me? And then he said, well, anyone who is developing any kind of pride, so I'm there to crush the pride, you know. So that's why I did this to you. But I'm also feeling bad that you're having such bodily pain. Okay, in future, people would go and offer you sarson ka tel, the groundnut oil. Yeah, that's groundnut oil. Yeah, sarso tel is known as, groundnut oil, maybe. So as you would pour this on your body, so you would get massage, and in this way, your injuries would be, you would recover from your injuries. Huh? So that would happen. So that is, we see that in India, those who want to become free from the influence of Shani, they put sarso oil, the groundnut oil on. What do you call that in English? Ground sarso tel is groundnut oil, maybe. No. Yeah. So in this way, so people pour this oil on his body. In this way, Shani was relieved from this pain. Yeah. Mustard oil. Yeah. Thank you, Vivek Prabhu. Yeah, that's mustard oil. So mustard oil. So people would pour mustard oil on your body in this way, that, that massage or mustard oil would relieve you from the pain. Yeah. So in this way, Hanuman is very, very powerful also. Thank you, Sonali. I got it. Yeah, mustard oil. So, and he's so powerful that actually Vali had the power that anyone who would come in front of Vali, that person would have his 50% strength now in the Vali. But when Hanumanji came before Vali, so Hanumanji is having so much of power that when 50% power was getting transferred to Vali, so Vali's body was about to burst. Yeah, Hanuman said, well, would you like to fight with me? He said, I'll fight with you later, but currently, because, you know, my body is about to burst with the power which I'm getting just by standing before you. Please, please go away. But Hanuman said, well, you are here to fight with me, right? Yeah. He immediately took off that locket from his neck, which was given by Indra, which had the power to take 50% of the power of the opponent. But he could not handle that much of power which Hanumanji was having. Yes. In fact, there was one, the mountain where he was staying, Sugri was staying. Vali had the courage that if he comes to that mountain, his head would burst to pieces. His head would burst into pieces. So Hanuman once caught hold of his feet and he was about to touch his feet to one of the rocks. And Vali was really struggling. Oh! He said, should I get your feet touched to this ground? And then he brought this 1 inch closer. Said, should I get this in touch? Yes. I do that. Vali said, no, please, 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 Hanuman, please, 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 don't do that. Please, 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 please. And then Hanumanji released him. So Vali knew that he's very powerful, but Hanumanji is way too powerful than Vali. Actually, when Vali, once he was doing tapasya, once when Ravana challenged him, so he got Ravana hair underneath his armpit and then he did his Gayatri. So he was so powerful. Vali was so powerful. And that Vali was like an insignificant mosquito before Hanumanji. So Hanumanji, how mighty Hanumanji would have been. Wow, that's really incredible. So in this way, we discuss about some of the pastimes of Sri Hanumanji, and we can learn some lessons from him about his loyalty, about his taste for the holy name, about his taste for Harikatha, his humble attitude, his service attitude. In fact, once he saw Mother Sita, that she's feeling the parting with Sindoor, which usually in India and in cultured families, the ladies, after getting married, so they fill in the parting with Sindhu. So he asked, oh, Mother Sita, you know, why do you fill this parting with Sindhu? She said, because then Sri Ram becomes happy. He said, oh, with this single line of this red color line, Ramji becomes happy. Hanumanji went to the market. He went to the market in Ayodhya. He said, okay, where is Sindhu? There was one bag full of Sindhu. He took the entire bag and poured on him. And then he was all red in Sindoor. And then he came to the assembly hall of Sri Ram. And Sri Ram said, Hanuman, what's this? He said, well, I met Mother Sita. Mother Sita told me that by filling in her parting when she puts in Sindoor, so that red color powder, and then she does that because you become happy. So I thought that if that single line of red color powder, if that makes you happy, in case if I am completely covered with Sindoor, then how much happy would you become? So that's why I went to the market, got this vermilion, this sindoor, and then just poured this vermilion upon myself so that you become not just happy, you become very, very happy, Sri Ram. And Hanuman is not thinking that what would people say. And in fact, when he was coming, people were laughing on him. Oh, Hanuman, what have you done? But he was least bothered about all of this. He just went to Sri Ram, just to please Sri Ram. He covered himself with vermilion, with this sindoor. That Sri Ram would be happy. Wow, Sri Ram would be happy. Great. So that's the loyalty of Hanumanji. That's the service attitude of Hanumanji. And it's so very dear to Sri Ram. All right, I'll stop here. If anybody has any question, you may ask questions.
Devotees can unmute themselves to ask the questions. You can all unmute yourself and ask questions.
I have one question. Okay. It's mustard oil or sesame oil, which people in India offer to Lord Sunny.
I think it is sarso tel. Sarso tel is mustard oil, right? I
see sarso tel is
mustard. Sarso tel is mustard oil. So they offer mustard oil.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yes.
Prabhu ji, main ek question puchna chahta hu aapse.
Puchhe ji, yes. What's the question?
Ye question hai ki क्या नाम है बलदेव जी थे शेषनाग के अवतार
यस लक्ष्मण जी इज इनकार्नेशन ऑफ अनंत शेष यस
तो सुभद्रा जी कौन थी
सुभद्रा जी इज इनकार्नेशन ऑफ योग माया
योग माया
योग माया द स्पिरिचुअल पोटेंसी ऑफ द लॉर्ड
ओके 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 तो उनके सिस्टर कैसे बन गई योग माया फिर
बिकॉज योग माया स्पिरिचुअल पोटेंसी सो स्पिरिचुअल पोटेंसी कैन कम एज सिस्टर कैन कम एज मदर कैन कम एज बिलवेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ श्रीमती राधिका That's spiritual potency. So Yog Maya. In fact, Mother Yashoda, she was blessed with twins. So that's Nandanandan Krishna and also Yog Maya. And this Yog Maya was taken by Vasudevji. And he brought Vasudev Krishna along with him. So Vasudev Krishna merged into Nandanandan Krishna. And Yog Maya was taken by Vasudevji to Mathura. And which was as thrown by Kansa in the sky. And then that Yog Maya, She said, well, the eighth child of Devaki has already appeared. So very soon you will meet your climax. You will meet your death. So this. So then when she made this announcement and then she is there in an unmanifest form. But then she appears in Dwarka Lila. So we do not hear of any childhood pastimes of Subhadra. We only hear Dwarka pastimes. In Dwarka, all of a sudden we see, oh, well, there is Subhadra now. But Subhadra is none other than who is sister of Lord Shri Krishna. As she also came from Mother Yashoda because Mother Yashoda had twins, Nandanandan Krishna, as well as the Yog Maya. Yeah. Later on, she manifests her Leela as Subhadra in Dwarka.
Hare Krishna, Pragna Mata Ji, you can ask the question, Pragna Ji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu Ji.
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Prabhu Ji, my question is ki. अगर जैसे कि हनुमान जी का सर्विस एटीट्यूड था तो अगर जैसे कभी कभी हम अपनी बात करें कि अगर कभी कभी सर्विस करते करते हम थक जाते कि अब और नहीं मतलब फेड अप तो क्या करना
ओके समटाइम्स वी कम फेड अप व्हाइल डूइंग सर्विसेज यस देन
तो मतलब फिर क्या करें कैसे करेक्ट करें अपने आप को
एक्चुअली व्हाई डू वी बिकम फेड अप यू नो व्हाई बिकॉज़ व्हेन वी आर वर्किंग विद द इंटेंशन ऑफ टू ग्रेटिफाई आवर सेंसेस Then you become fed up because now my senses are not getting gratified. So I'm not satisfied. So since I'm not satisfied, so I'm just feeling fed up. But when we do this with service attitude, not for myself, but for the Lord. Not for myself, but for the Lord. Not for myself. When there is no expectation at all. As soon as there is expectation, then there comes frustration. Frustration is directly proportional to expectations. More there are expectations, more we should be ready for our frustrations. So sometimes when we do services, We do it with a sense that, okay, hume achha lagega. You would feel good by doing service. You would feel good. And since we have this attitude that I will feel good, and when we don't start feeling good, we say, well, I'm fed up of the services. So we should do service with selfless attitude. We should be grateful that I got the chance to serve. So we should have the attitude of gratitude that I got a chance. So with this attitude, we should serve. And that's what's required, actually. And then you're not frustrated. You not feel exploited. You not feel used. You not feel, oh, well, I was over-engaged. You not feel like that. So selflessness is a hallmark. It's an internal inherent quality of genuine service. Selflessness.
Hare Krishna.
Well, I cannot hear you.
Hello. Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Yes, Sonia Mataji, yes.
Yes, Prabhu ji, मैं ये जानना चाहती थी जैसे हम भगवान को वो ऑफर करते हैं राम जी का जन्म दिवस
था आदि देयर इज लॉट ऑफ डिस्टरबेंस इन योर ऑडियो एक्चुअली दैट्स व्हाई आई एम नॉट एबल टू हियर यू क्लियरली
ओके मैं बात में पूछने चलिए फिर थोड़ा सा
आई एम सॉरी
आप टाइप करके भेजिए मैं आपको मैं प्रभु जी को पूछ लूंगा या प्रभु जी देख लेंगे मैसेज में टाइप कर दीजिएगा चाहे
ओके ओके प्रभु जी
शिवम शर्मा जी पूछ सकते हैं अशोक शर्मा जी पूछ सकते हैं
प्रभु जी आई ऑडिबल प्रभु जी
यस यस
यस यू आर ऑडिबल सो बिफोर वी प्रोसीड I would just like to speak out the name of the courses which are being offered by Vedaversity. Laghu Bhagavatamrit, Uddhav Gita, Real History of Ancient India, the basic module, Sri Brahma Sahita, Diploma in Srimad Bhagavatam, Diploma in Concepts of Vedic Cosmology, Sanskrit Pronunciation Course, Diploma in Sanskrit Grammar, Hari Namrit Vyakaran Module 1, Madhuri Kadamini, Krishigo Raksha, Mridanga Course, and Kartal Course. So please enroll yourself in these courses and get benefited. Okay, yes, please, now, please go ahead with your question.
Thank you for your wonderful class. My question is that, like, as we know, the Hanumanji is very dear to Lord Ram. So yes. if he wanted to please the Lord Hari, so how to, so we know that to please the Lord Hari, we want mercy of the his devotee. So my question is that how to please the Hanuman? How to please Hanuman? Hanumanji, yes.
Okay. You know, Hanumanji is also like Guru. Guru becomes happy when he becomes servants of the Lord. So that is when we chant the names of the Lord, Guru becomes happy. So taking to the path of pure bhakti will please Hanuman. Okay, next question.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Pranam.
Yes, Hare Krishna, Pranam Ataji.
Prabhuji, jab Lanka mein Hanuman ji aate hai na, jab dekhte to seedha Hanuman ji ke saath kyun nahi jaate hai?
Oh, I see. Okay. Actually, because Sita knew that Sri Ram is coming to rescue him. So that's why in case she goes along with Hanumanji, so the very purpose of Sri Ram coming to Lanka would be foiled. So she didn't want that plan of the Lord should be foiled. You know, hero doesn't come to rescue the heroine, but just somebody else comes and rescues the heroine. Well, it's like a rasa bhas. So that's why she did not go. That was for one reason. Another reason is that she didn't want to get touch of any other person, because she only wants to get touched by Sri Ram only. Even though Hanumanji is all pure and he sees Sita as Mother Sita, even then she had this feeling that I should be touched by only Sri Ram. That was her chastity actually. And also, of course, the greater reason is that Sri Ram is especially coming, searching after me. So that is, I should make his mission successful. So that's why she did not go. And also, of course, she knew being Yog Mahashakti that Lord Ram is coming to Lanka to kill Ravana, who is very powerful. So that's why he has to come here and Ravana being killed by Sri Ram. So all these were the reasons why she did not go with Hanumanji.
Okay, dhanyavad Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji, Hanumanji is monkey. And
he's not monkey. No.
Okay.
Yeah. He's not monkey.
Okay.
He's very special.
Okay, Prabhuji. And Prabhuji, second one, three medicines you told when Hanumanji bringing. Can you just repeat the name, please?
Which name?
Three names you told that is
medicine. When three names bringing, of the medicines. Of the medicines.
Medicine, yeah.
Amrit. Yeah, one is Mrita Sanjeevani. Mrita Sanjeevani makes the unconscious person come to life. Okay. And then there's Shalya Karani. Shalya Karani, it heals the wounds. And Sandhani joins the fractured bones. All right.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
All right.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna. Yes, Galaxy S20 Plus. What a unique name.
Prabhuji, my question is, the mountain that Hanumanji brought was kept in Lanka only. It is not returned back to Himalaya.
No, it was returned back.
Returned back.
Yes, of course it was returned back. And that's what I told, that entire operation was executed in single day. Bringing the mountain with all the obstacles in between. And then
But when we see the Ramayana, Ramayan created by this in television serial, there it is shown that it's not returned back.
No, they have not shown this that he went back, but it is also not shown that it remained there. So we assume that it remained there. Okay. Neither of the thing is shown, whether he took it back or he did not take it back. But neither of the thing is shown. But it does not mean that he did not return. But actually, he took it back.
Okay. Okay, Prabhuji. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yes. Nupur Pawar.
Ji. Prabhuji, mujhe aise puchna hai ki Hanuman ji incarnation of a Shiva. So, and Ram, he is a servant of a Ram. So, Ram is chanting the name of and Hanuman is chanting name of his master, Rama. So, how is
I cannot listen to your question.
Hanuman ji, Ram ka Shiv ka incarnation.
Yes.
So, Hanuman ji, Shiv, matlab, servant ho gaye Ram ke.
Yes.
So Ram ka Ram Shiv aur Shiv Ram ka naam lete aur Hanuman ji yahan pe
Ram. No, Lord Ram doesn't chant Shiva's name. That is shown by the secular presenters of the television TV serial programs. Lord Ram doesn't chant names of Lord Shiva. He loves Lord Shiva a lot. But Ram ji is Lord, Shivji is a devotee. And that's why we see whenever he would come as a devotee. Shivji is acting like a devotee to Lord Shri Krishna. Hanuman ji is acting like a devotee to Shri Ram. And then Murari Gupta in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Leela, he's acting as a servant of Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He always comes and acts like a servant, as a devotee.
I got
it. Okay.
But Prabhuji, we see that in Rameshwaram, Lord Ram has worshipped Shiva.
Yes.
So how do you relate that?
So he worships his devotees because he loves his devotees. He also becomes chariot driver of Arjun. That does not mean that Arjun has become now God and Krishna has become a devotee. When Krishna, when he is holding the slippers of Nanda Maharaj on his head, it does not mean Nanda Maharaj has now. It does not mean that Nanda Maharaj has now become God and Krishna has become a devotee. Krishna serves his devotee like that because he worships his devotee. He serves his devotee. But that does not mean that Lord becomes devotee and the devotee becomes Lord. No, it's not like that. Have you seen sometimes mother feeding Sarilac to the child? And she says, oh, baby will have Sarilac. Yeah. Yes. And then baby also puts his hand inside Sarilac. And he says, mama. And then mama also takes, mama ne bhi Sarilac khaya. Mama also took Sarilac. Wow. So baby is feeding Sarilac to mother and mother is feeding Sarilac to the baby. Right? Yet mother is mother and baby is baby. So Lord worships his devotees. The devotees are worshipping the Lord. But that does not mean that both are lords. So it's not like that. So Rameshwaram means Ram is the Lord of whom? Who is having Lord Ram as his master. So Rameshwar. Not that Ram ke, not that Lord Ram's master. No. It means that for whom Lord Ram is master. That's the meaning of Rameshwar. And Gopeshwar. Gopiya jinki Ishwar hai. Gopis are master of whom? That person. That is Lord Shiva. So Gopeshwar. Not that Gopeshwar means Gopiyo ke Ishwar. That means he's a lord of the gopis. No, it's not like that. Gopeshwar means to whom the gopis belong as his master. So Gopeshwar. Gopiya jinki Ishwar hai. Gopis are the master of this person. Gopeshwar. Similarly, Rameshwar is Ram jinki Ishwar hai. Rameshwar. Lord Ram is master of whom? Of that person. That is Lord Shiva. That's why his name is Rameshwar, Gopeshwar. Like that.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you. I think
Hare Krishna.
Given time has been a little time has been.
Hare Krishna, all Prabhu. Right, so we are done.
Thank you.
Prabhu, one last question.
Okay, last question.
Okay.
Prabhu, actually my sister ne pucha tha mere se ek bar. तो yes. मैं पूछता हूँ प्रभु उन्होंने ये पूछा था कि कृष्ण जी किस राधा जी समर्पित थे कृष्ण जी के लिए तो कृष्ण जी ने मतलब दूसरी शादी क्यों कर ली
क्या चीज व्हाट इज दैट व्हाई कृष्णा मैरिड अदर लेडीज इवन व्हेन श्रीमती राधिका वाज कंप्लीटली सरेंडर्ड टू कृष्णा इज इट लाइक दैट्स अ क्वेश्चन राइट
यस प्रभु
या सो ओके टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग राम कथा आई डिडंट नो दैट यू आर सो मच इन कृष्ण कथा इन कृष्णास लीला बट एनीवेज बट फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट Lord doesn't need to marry Shrimati Radhika, even though he got married to Shrimati Radhika. But he doesn't have to marry. Why? Because Shakti doesn't have to marry Shaktiman. Shaktiman doesn't have to marry Shakti. In this world, to keep the social structure into the boundaries of etiquette, of culture, you know, of morality, that's why we need marriage as an institution in the human civilization. But that's not applicable to
My
God.
Question,
Does sun marry the sunshine? No. Does sugar marry the sweetness? No. Does fire marry the heat? No. So energetic never marries energy. So Shrimati Radhika, she's energy of Krishna. So energetic energy never, they don't marry. Although in the Leela, they married. In Bhandirvan, Brahmaji got them married. But their rasa is beyond marriage, that parakya rasa. Is that her beloved? Is paramour. So all these different, all the Lakshmis, all those, the queens in Dwarka, they are expansions of Shrimati Radhika. Shrimati Radhika, she is Adi Shakti. And all others are the expansions of Shrimati Radhika. Devi Krishna Mahi Prokta Radhika Para Devata. Sarva Lakshmi Mahi Sarva. Kanti Samohini Para. So that's Shrimati Radhika. Sarva Lakshmi Mahi Sarva. That means all the queens even, all those which are like goddess of fortune, they are coming out of Shrimati Radhika. And so that is Shrimati Radhika is expanding herself to give pleasure to Krishna in a different rasa, Swakya rasa. So that is, we cannot say, well, she did not marry this lady, he got married to some other lady, because we are imposing the mundane conception on the Supreme Lord. We cannot impose mundane conception on the Supreme Lord. Love triangle, kuch kuch hota hai, dil to pagal hai. Well, all these love triangles and love quadruples and love hexagons, they happen in the material world, but they are not applicable on God.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank
so
you.
I think we'll stop here now. I think the time is up. Thank you very much, Blessed Prabhu, for inviting me. I will glorify Hanumanji
Hare Krishna,
on
Krishna.
The occasion of Hanumanji. I think so grateful to you. Bajrang Bali ki jai. Param Ram Bhakti Shri Hanumanji ki jai.